Assalamualaikum students, I am Sananjum, your English teacher. Today we are going to learn about relative pronouns in clauses. Before moving towards the relative pronouns, it is necessary for us to look into the clauses. Basically, we have two types of clauses, independent clause or dependent clause. Independent clause is that which can stand on its own, and dependent, as it is clear from its word, its name, that it needs some assistant. Dependent clause is also known as subordinate clause, and independent clause is also having one more name, that is main clause. So here comes the definition of the clause. Clause is a group of related words that contains a subject and a verb. Now it can be used in two ways. Clause can be used as a sentence or as a part of sentence. When a clause is giving the complete meaning, it will be working as a sentence. And when it has the incomplete meaning, it will be working as a part of sentence. Look at the examples below. He is a news reporter. Here, there is a subject, there is a verb, and this is conveying the full meaning. So it is working as a sentence. She loves music, she is subject, loves, verb, and music is object. It is conveying the full sense. So it is working as a sentence. Where he stays. Now there is subject, there is verb, but it is not conveying its full meaning. So it is working as a part of sentence. Now it is clear that clause can perform its function in two ways, as a sentence and as a part of sentence. We can define clause as a group of words having a subject and a predicate. Subject is one that is the doer of action, and predicate means action it performs. In the first example, the big green frog, it is a subject, while the action he performed is a predicate. What action did he perform? He jumped across the log, so it is a predicate, similar to the other examples. Now, types of clauses. There are two types of clauses, as we have read, independent clause or main clause, dependent clause or subordinate clause. So these are two types. One can stand on its own and one needs assistant to convey its meaning. Independent clause. An independent clause has a subject and a verb and can stand alone as a sentence. For example, they work in marketing department. This is the complete sentence. So it is the independent clause. What shall we do? It is also an independent clause. Dependent clause. Dependent clause has a subject and a predicate, but it cannot stand alone as a sentence. There are three types of subordinate clauses: noun clause, adjective clause, and adverb clauses. We will learn about these clauses or these types in our further lectures. Now moving towards the relative pronouns. So these are the relative pronouns: who, when, which, whose, and where. What is a relative pronoun? A relative pronoun is one which introduces a dependent or subordinate clause. Means now these words, who, where, when, whose, and which, they are, when we are going to use them in sentences, they are going to introduce the dependent clause. Dependent clause means which cannot stand alone. It relates the dependent clause to the noun it refers in the main clause. In simple words, it will introduce the dependent clause that will be telling us more about the noun which is present in the main clause. Look at the examples below. Everyone cheered the player. It is the main clause. Who scored 3 goals. Now, who is the relative pronoun? Scored 3 goals. These are subordinate clause. So here this relative pronoun is going to give us information about the player that is present in the main clause. We saw a film which was very amusing. Now here which is a relative pronoun, and it is giving us information about film. What do these relative pronouns do? They give additional information about something. For example, a vandal is somebody who damages building or objects. Here it is giving us information about the vandal, that what does he do? Linking up two sentences. He likes the book, one sentence. We gave to him two sentences. Now if we want to convert it in one sentence, it will be like, he likes the book which we gave to him. So here relative pronoun is linking two sentences. They look like WH question words, but they aren't. Now where we can use them? These relative pronouns can be used. Who is used when we are talking about the people? And when we are going to give information about things, we will be using which. Martin Freeman is an actor who plays Bilbo in the film. Here we are talking about the person. That's why we used who. I lost my wallet which my mother gave me. Now here wallet is a thing, so we use relative pronoun which. Whose is used for possessions? Sam is the boy whose dog won the competition. Here Sam's possession is dog. We are talking about that dog. We are talking about his possession. That's why we used whose. Where is used for place? The hotel where we slept was excellent. Now when we are talking about a specific place, we will be using relative pronoun where. When is used for time. 2019 is the year when I won art competition. So these were your relative pronouns. One is used for telling us about the persons, one is used to tell us about the things, then possession, then time and place. Now you have to memorize that where these relative pronouns use. Now come towards the activity. Now here is a blank for you. You are going to fill it with a suitable relative pronoun. The woman works in the reception is French. Now what will come here? Woman, focus. Here we are talking about people. For people we use, yes, think. Yes, right. We will use who. The house dash is next to mine is for sale. Here we are talking about house. So house is people. It is included in persons. No. Then it is a thing. Okay. For things we use. Very good. Which. That's the hotel dash we spent our vacations. What will come here? Here we are talking about place. Okay. For place we use. Good. Where. Danny dash father is a judge is studying law. Now here we are talking about the possession. So what will come here? Whose. Good. July and August are the months dash it's the hottest in France. Now we are talking about a specific time period, and for time period, very good, when will be coming. So here is an assignment for you people. I hope that you have understood the topic of relative pronouns and clauses as well. So by using these relative pronouns, complete this assignment and send me on my email ID, that is missanjum07@gmail.com. Thank you, students.